Hello friends, in this video we will see the complete procedure of design of spur gear step by step in very easy manner by using PSG Design Databook. So let's start. So the question is, a pair of spur gear is required to transmit 15 kW power, the input shaft rotates at 576 rpm and the output shaft rotates at 144 rpm. Design the gear. So let's start given data first. Spur gear pair is given, input shaft N1 is 576 rpm. Output shaft N2 is 144 rpm. Power is also given 15 kW. Now, step 1, basic selections. Here we have to assume some parameters or select some parameters on which we are going to design our spur gear among the different options available, like tooth profile, pressure angle, type of tooth, quality of cut, type of system, type of gearing, gearbox layout. This should be given in the question itself, but if not given, then we have to assume by ourselves. By giving an appropriate reason why we are choosing this option. So tooth profile can be cycloidal or involute. Here I am choosing involute profile because it is easy to cut and pressure angles remains constant in the involute profile. And if you talk about pressure angles, three standard pressure angles are there: 14.5 degree, 20 degree and 25 degree. So most common pressure angle is 20 degree and justification compromise between cost and size of entire gearbox. Third, type of tooth. We are selecting full depth as the power transmission full depth tooth is smooth. Fourth, quality of cut. So the options are commercial cut, carefully cut, precision cut. Let's select precision cut to avoid pitting failure and dynamic loading. Fifth, type of system. So the system could be open system or closed system. Here I choose closed system to prevent abrasive wear. Sixth, type of gearing. Corrected, non-corrected. Let's select non-corrected, which is easy to design and interchangeable. And last, gearbox layout, which could be symmetrical or unsymmetrical. Let's select unsymmetrical, which is compact and less costly. Next step, to find out number of teeth on pinion Z1 and number of teeth on gear Z2. So the standard formula to avoid the interference between the gears to find out the number of teeth on pinion is 2FO divided by sin square alpha. Here FO is the height factor and alpha is the pressure angle. As we have selected full depth gear tooth, so the value of FO is 1 and pressure angle is 20. Both these values are given in the PSG page number 8.1. So here are the values of height factor and pressure angle. After solving this equation, we get number of teeth on pinion 18. As we all know, the reduction ratio is output shaft speed upon input shaft speed, N2 upon N1. So N2 is given 576 rpm and N1 is given 144 rpm. So we get reduction ratio I equal to 4. And we also know that reduction ratio is also equal to Z2 by Z1. Here we know the value of I, that is 4. And just now we have calculated number of teeth on pinion Z1. From here we get Z2 equal to 72. So hence we get number of teeth on pinion and gear. Step 3, calculation of Lewis form factor. We must find out this value to find out or to decide which member will be weaker, pinion or gear. And the equation is y equal to pi into small y. This equation is given on the PSG page number 8.50 and here small y is the Lewis constant which will be selected according to the pressure angle. So here on the PSG 8.50 page, this is the Lewis equation y equal to pi into y. And here on the bottom right corner, you will find different values of Lewis constant for different values of pressure angle. Here we have selected 20 degree pressure angle. Hence, we will select the value of Y for 20 degree pressure angle. We will use this formula for pinion and gear both, replacing Z by Z1 and Z2. We have calculated Z1 equal to 18 and Z2 equal to 72. After solving these equations, we get Y1 equal to 0.325 and Y2 equal to 0.444. Next step. Step 4, material selection from PSG 8.5. So let's go to PSG page number 8.5 and here is the alloy steel material. So the selected material in a tabular form like this: elements, material, design bending stress sigma b, design crushing stress sigma c. First, pinion. So select the material for pinion which has the higher strength. So 40 Ni2 alloy steel has the higher strength in compare with the 15 Ni2 alloy steel. So we will select this material as a pinion which has design bending stress 400 Newton per mm square and design crushing stress 1100 Newton per mm square. And for gear, select alloy steel 15 Ni2 which has design bending stress 320 newton per mm square and design crushing stress 950 newton per mm square. But if you see in the PSG, these values are given in the kg per centimeter square. And if you want to convert those values into newton per mm square, then simply divide by 10. Here material was not given in the question, hence we are selecting as per our convenience. But if material is given in the question, then we have to find these values sigma b and sigma c by using PSG design data book. You can find design bending stress sigma b by using a formula which is given on the PSG page number 8.18, and you can find the value of design crushing stress sigma c by using the formula which is given on the PSG 8.16. Okay, next step. Step 5. Determination of weaker member. For pinion, the formula is S1 equal to design bending stress sigma b1 into Lewis form factor y1. And for gear, the formula is S2 equal to design bending stress sigma b2 into Lewis form factor y2. In previous step, we have selected the material for pinion and gear, which has the value of sigma b1 and sigma b2 as 400 and 320. And we have already calculated the values of Lewis form factor. For pinion it is 0.325 and for gear it is 0.444. So after solving this equation, we get 130 newton per mm square for pinion, and for gear we get 142 newton per mm square. So out of these two values, we have to select minimum value, which will be weaker member. So here pinion is a weaker member, hence it should be designed. Now we know the weaker member, that is pinion. Hence, we will use the values of pinion only up to the last step. Step 6. Design of weaker member, and that is pinion. Here, we have two criteria on which we can design the weaker member. First, design based on bending, and second, design based on contact strength. So here I am using first criteria, design based on bending, and that is given on PSG page number 8.13a. So let's go to this page. So here are the formulas of module for different types of gears by using bending criteria. We are designing spur gear, hence we have to select the formula of spur gear. So here is the formula of module in which Mt is there. Mt is the torque. We can find the torque by using power equation 2 pi Nt divided by 60. Power is already given in the question, that is 15 kilowatt, and we are designing the pinion, hence we have to use pinion speed, that is N1, 576 rpm. So we get torque equal to 248.68 newton meter, but putting it into the newton millimeter. One thing you should note, that this value you can't put into the module formula, because this is the actual torque and we have to put design torque. So we have to multiply it by a design factor, Kd into K. You will get this Kd into K value from PSG page number 8.15. So here is the design torque formula and here is the Kd into K values. And we have selected unsymmetric gearbox, hence the value is 1.5. So multiplying this 1.5 into torque, so we get the design torque, 373020 newton mm. Now putting this value into the module formula. Here we have to put the values with respect to pinion only. Y1, 0.325. Design bending stress sigma b1, 400. Psi is the constant value, that is 10, which is also given on the PSG page number 8.14. At the bottom line, along with the b equal to 10 into module, and z1 is 18. After solving this equation, we get module equal to 2.52. But this is the actual module. To find out the design module, we have to increase this value by 20%. So module equal to 3.024. But we can't use this value either. Selecting next highest standard value, which is given on the PSG page number 8.2 in a tabular form. So here, 4mm module is a standard module, which is near to 3.024. Hence, our final module value is 4mm. Here our design is complete. Now we have to check whether this design is safe or unsafe with respect to induced stresses and loading conditions. So first we will check contact stresses. In this also two criteria are there. First, design based on contact strength, and second, design based on bending. So we already used design based on bending criteria in the previous step. So here we have to use design based on contact strength, which is there on PSG page number 8.13. So let's go on page number 8.13. So here is the list of formulas for different types of gears for the criteria design based on contact strength. We are designing spur gear, hence we have to use spur gear formula. So here is the formula for contact stresses induced, sigma c, for spur gear design. Here I is the reduction ratio, which is 4. We have calculated it in the second step. And A is the center distance, You will get the formula to find out center distance on the PSG page number 8.22. So here is the PSG and here is the center distance formula, in which we know module which is 4, Z1 is 18 and Z2 is 72. So we get center distance A is equal to 180 mm. Now B is the face width, which is also given in the PSG page number 8.14. So the formula is B equal to 10 into module. Here module is 4, hence we get B equal to 40 mm. Now E is the Young's modulus. You can get the value from PSG 8.14 page. So these are the values of Young's modulus for different materials. For steel, it is generally 2.15 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. Remember this point always, PSG will give you in kg per centimeter square, and if you want to take it in Newton per mm square, then simply divide it by 10 and you will get in Newton per mm square. And the last one is torque, MT. Here design torque we have to consider, 373020 Newton mm. So after solving this equation we get contact stresses sigma c equal to 1029 Newton per mm square, which is less than design contact stresses 1100 Newton per mm square. This design contact stress 1100 is fixed for the material we have selected. We saw this in material selection step. Hence we can say that this design is safe in contact stresses. Now second checking of dynamic load. Here the condition for safe design is FS should be greater than FD. FS is the strength of the gear and FD is the dynamic load acting on the gear. This condition is also there in the PSG page number 8.51. Let's check it. So here is the condition. To find out strength of the gear FS, a direct formula is there, which is given on the PSG page number 8.50. So here is the formula. Now sigma B1 is the design bending stress. We know already 400. B is the face width, that is 40. Y1 is the 0.325 and module is the 4. So we get the strength of the gear FS, 20.8 kN. Now dynamic load acting on the gear FD, which is also there in the PSG just below FS. FD equal to FT into CV. Here to find out FT, you can take the formula from PSG page number 8.57, and to find out CV, you can take the formula from PSG page number 8.51. So here is the formula of FT for spur gear, and here is the formula of CV for different types of cut. We have selected precision cut, hence we have to select this formula. Now in this formula we know torque 373020 Newton mm, but we don't know velocity Vm, but we can find out velocity by using pi d and divided by 60. Here we know n1, that is 576 rpm, and diameter we can find out by using module into z, 4 into 18 will give 72 mm, but we have to put it here into meter because velocity will be come in meter per second, hence diameter is 0.072 meter. After solving this equation, we get velocity 2.17 meter per second. And putting this value in FD, we get dynamic load acting on the gear is 13.13 kN, which is less than the FS. Hence, we can say that our design is safe in dynamic loading. Now, third checking, that is checking of wear load. Step 9. If they mention in the question, that is check for wear load also, then and only you have to check for wear load. And the condition for safe design is FW should be greater than FD. You can find this condition in the PSG also, PSG page number 8.51, just below the dynamic loading condition. Here we have already calculated the FD value, that is 13.13 kN just before this step. And the formula to find out FW is also there in the PSG, in page number 8.51. Here you will get the formula to find out FW, in which we know D1 72 mm, Q we have to find out by using this formula, 2 into reduction ratio upon reduction ratio plus 1. We know reduction ratio, which is 4. We get the value of Q as 1.6. B is the face width, we already know 40 mm. And this is the formula to find out the K. These both the formulas of K and Q you can find in the PSG, page number 8.51. So here on top right corner, you can find the formula to find out K and Q. In this formula, we know sigma C, 1029 Newton per mm square. Here the sigma c is not design contact stress, it is actual contact stress, 1029 Newton per mm square. Alpha is the pressure angle, that is 20 degree, and Young's modulus is same for both the pinion and gear, that is 2.15 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. And after putting these values in the K and solving this equation, then we can find K equal to 3.36 Newton per mm square.
And by putting these all the four values in the Fw equation, we get wear load, that is 15.48 kN. Here we see that wear load is greater than dynamic load. Hence we can say that our design is also safe in wear load. By chance, if our design fails, then we have to increase the value of module manually. And by adjusting the value of module, we have to satisfy the conditions of loading and stresses. Step 10. Constructional details. A direct formula is there to find out the type of gear. For the pinion, it is N1 equal to 0.55 into 4th root of PC into Z1 square. PC is the circular pitch, that is pi into module. Pi into 4 will give 12.56 mm. But here we have to put it into centimeter, 1.256 centimeter. And Z1 we know 18. So after solving this equation, we get 2.47. And for gear, N2 equal to 0.55 into 4th root of PC into Z2 square. So circular pitch will be same because module is same for both the pinion and gear. And Z2 is 72. So we get N2 equal to 4.94. And to find out which type of gear are they, we have to prefer this table, which shows if N is less than and equal to 3, our gear should be integral type. Less than or equal to 4, gear should be solid type. Less than or equal to 5, gear should be web type. And if N is greater than 5, then it should be arm type. I hope you already know what is solid type, web type and arm type gears. So here we can say that our pinion should be integral type gear and our another gear should be a web type gear. Next step 11, design of shaft. Here we already know the torque formula. Mt equal to pi by 16 into ds cube into tau. Here we already know Mt 373020 Nm, and the value of tau, that is shear stress for alloy steels, are 45 Nm/mm². So after solving this equation, we get diameter of input shaft is 34.82 mm, but we have to take a little higher value for safety factor. Let's say input shaft diameter is 40 mm. To find out output shaft diameter, we have to use relation formula ds2 upon ds1 equal to cube root of I. Here I is the reduction ratio, which is 4, and ds1 we already calculated 40 mm. From here we get ds2 equal to 65 mm. So input shaft diameter 40 mm and output shaft diameter 65 mm. At the end you can summarize your design, which will create more impact on your solution. And for summarization you can prefer PSG page number 8.22. Simply you can make a table of nomenclature, notation and value columns. First module, we get 4 mm, center distance 180 mm, number of teeth on pinion 18 and number of teeth on gear 72, width of gear, that is face width, 40 mm, height factor ref is 1, bottom clearance C is 0.25 module, hence we get 1 mm, tooth depth 2.25 into module, so we get 9 mm, diameter of input shaft ds1 40 mm and diameter of output shaft ds2 65 mm. Finally, we have completed our design. Repeat the steps in all the types of problems. I wish you all the very best for your university exams. And if you feel this video will help you in your preparations, then please like this video. And if you are new to this channel, then please subscribe to my channel. And finally, thanks for watching.